Hello everyone, today we are going to explain the mechanical differences between a normal spring and a spring with mechanical damper. The spring mass system is a very common example in physics and in control systems. It is composed by a mass m tied to a spring with elastic constant k. We consider that the origin of the vertical axis x is placed at the balance point where the weight is equal to the elastic force. If the spring is pushed or pulled, the elastic force by the spring will be proportional to the displacement. By trying this piston, we can have a feeling of the spring forces. Even though we can feel the spring's resistance, we can compress and stretch the piston with fast movements. Now, let's take a look at the second one. This piston is covered in oil, and this oil offers considerably more resistance than the air. When the spring is compressed or stretched with fast movements, the mechanical resistance is considerably stronger. This happens because the oil acts as a mechanical damper. We can better understand the behavior of the damped piston by looking at an extension of the spring mass system. To the former spring mass system, we added a third element, the damper. The damper forces are proportional and opposite to the speed of the damped body. These concepts of spring and damping forces are very important for magnetic levitation. Spring forces are responsible for adjusting the average position of a suspended body. Damper forces are responsible for neutralizing oscillation in the system. Without damping, a magnetically suspended body would keep oscillating forever around the average position and never achieve true balance. But, if a magnetic bearing is combined with damping effect, oscillation stops and balance is achieved. Thank you for watching this video. Stay with us along the next ones.